TyreK is Tire Pressure Monitoring System is a system that monitors your vehicle's tire pressure in real time. Sensors send the tire pressure to a monitor in your vehicle so that you can keep an eye on your tire pressure while driving. The system is there to detect abnormal tire pressure, prevent tire blowouts, prevent tire imbalance, and prolong tire life. The TyreK Tire Pressure Monitoring System consists of four pressure sensors fitted to the tires of your vehicle. The system is available with either external or internal sensors. The sensors wirelessly transmits the tire pressure in real time to a solar-powered monitor in your vehicle. In the case of a slow or fast deflation, the monitor will set off an alarm. These alarms are set to go off if the tire pressure goes under the set low pressure mark or above the set high pressure mark. To install the system on your vehicle, use the provided double-sided stickers or the non-slip mat. Switch the monitor on by pressing and holding the minus button until the home screen appears. Install the four sensors on the tires. For external sensors, screw the nut on the valve and then the sensor. Lock the sensor with a lock nut. For internal sensors, fit the sensor inside the tire. The position of each sensor will be indicated on the sensor itself. This can be done by your tire dealer. The position of each sensor will be displayed on the monitor. It's important to note that if one or more of the tire's pressures are not indicated on the monitor, the wheels need to move. A simple drive around the block should fix this. The plus button on the side of the monitor doubles as the menu button. Press and hold this button until the screen displays bar PSI. Using the minus buttons, go through the settings menu until you get to the option you want to change. The first option is the pressure unit setting, used for changing the monitor's measuring units between bar and PSI. If you press the minus button, the next option displayed is the temperature unit setting, where you can choose between degrees centigrade or degrees Fahrenheit. If you press the minus button again, the high pressure setting will be displayed. Here you can set the tire pressure that will sound the unit's high pressure alarm. If you press the minus button again, the low pressure setting will be displayed. Here you can set the tire pressure that will sound the unit's low pressure alarm. If you press the minus button again, the high temperature setting will be displayed. Here you can set the temperature that will sound the unit's alarm. If you press the minus button one more time, you will reach the tire exchange setting. For internal sensors, you can use this to exchange tire positions after wheel rotations. A full explanation of the procedure will be given later in this video. If you press the minus button one more time, you will have cycled back to the first setting menu, indicated by bar PSI displayed on the screen. If you want to change something, tap the plus button once. The option will start to flash. You can cycle through options using the minus button. If you have cycled past your desired setting, simply keep pressing the minus button until it shows up again. When the necessary changes have been made, press the plus button once to accept and save changes. When you are done changing settings, hold down the plus button until the home screen appears. The tire pressure will not be displayed immediately. You will have to drive the vehicle to activate the sensors. When rotating the tires, you will have to swap the tire positions on the tire pressure monitoring system. After rotating the wheels, press and hold the plus button, then press the minus button 5 times and the wheel positions, labeled from 1 to 4, will be displayed. Press the plus button once and the number 1 will start to flash. Using the minus button, select the wheel to be swapped and press the plus button to confirm. Repeat until all tires are indicated in the correct position. After confirming the fourth wheel, press and hold the plus button to return to the home screen. Please note that if you go into the setting mode again, the monitor will once again show the positions from 1 to 4. This is correct. When one or more of the sensors need to be replaced, the new sensor will need to be registered to the monitor of the tire pressure monitoring system. To register a new sensor onto the monitor, press the plus button 5 times. Use the minus button to select the relevant sensor to be registered. For internal sensors, inflate or deflate the tire slightly until the monitor makes one beep. For external sensors, simply screw the sensor onto the valve and the monitor will make one beep for confirmation. Repeat this process on each tire as necessary by selecting the relevant sensor on the monitor and either inflating or deflating the tire for internal sensors, or screwing the sensor onto the valve on external sensors. Press and hold the plus button to save and exit. The tire pressure monitoring system's sensors send information to the monitor, and the monitor will display the pressures last sent through. The sensors and monitor automatically enter sleep mode when the vehicle isn't in use, and until the wheels move again, the last received pressures will be displayed. If the monitor won't turn on, or the battery indicator has dropped to its lowest mark, use the provided USB cable to connect the monitor to an electrical power source to charge. The brightness of the monitor can be adjusted using the minus button. Batteries can be replaced on both external and internal sensors. Sensors can be bought separately. Included in the tire pressure monitor system's box is sensors, lock nuts, monitor, USB cable, wrench, mat, red double-sided stickers, spanner, and instructional booklet. Alternatively, with the internal sensors, you'll get internal sensors, valves, yellow valve label stickers, USB cable, monitor, mat, red double-sided stickers, spanners, screwdriver, screws, and instructional booklet. Get everything you need from Tire Care.